We'll be right back. Anyway, so King Snaker here. Now, we have some history, you guys. I mean, Sugar Daddy, what years were Sugar Daddy? Was that like
95 is when the
Sugar Daddy came around. For the radio listeners, maybe we should sound off some names to go with voices for people, because the video won't be done editing until probably like June with how long it takes me on this laptop. But
you work diligently then.
Yes. Yeah, until it crashes and then I have to rework it diligently again.
Nice.
But yeah, why don't we introduce ourselves across the board here, starting with you, Matt.
Matt, drummer.
Bill, vocals and rhythm guitar.
Matt Kahn, bass player.
Primarily lead guitar.
Okay. So now, you guys, you were saying 90 what?
95 is when we first, us three first initially, which, and the funny thing is these guys were in a band before Sugar Daddy started.
Okay.
So these, you know, us three here have been together since 95.
Us three being Matt Farn and Bill Jenkins and Brian Merritt for the radio audience.
Yes. So where did you find Matt then?
Sleeping on the street. We were in other bands when we were in high school and all growing up. And long story short, as I went to California, when I came back in 2001, we regrouped the band.
Okay.
And put Matt in on bass.
So there was a space.
Yeah, there was a space.
So, all right, because I mean, to me, it's like I've been to like three different Clutch shows in my life. They all blur together. And it's like the one that always stands out in my mind was The Chance. Mm-hmm. And that was Sugar Daddy. And that, I mean, was it that long ago? Was that 2001?
Like 2003.
Three?
Yeah.
Okay. And so when did Sugar Daddy stop and then King Snake begin?
2006.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you drafted him for King Snake then, or was he
we were already together. Yeah. He was in Sugar Daddy. We basically, so it's the exact same band.
Yeah. Okay.
We're playing a trick on people.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Don't tell anybody.
A couple times.
Yeah.
For anyone listening, we're lying.
Yeah.
Now, so you guys went to high school together?
Me and Matt Kahn did. Yeah, we went to high school together.
Okay, and that, now you guys are from where? Outside Philly or?
Yeah, Delaware County.
Delaware County. Are from over there.
Yeah, all Delaware County.
Yeah. Oh, okay. You guys have been starting to, I mean, you're working on your third record and stuff. You're starting to play out a lot more. I know you all got like, there's like families and stuff involved. And what's your big picture plan at this point? What is it you're trying to accomplish?
Saving up for Christmas.
I was going to say, he's the politician. He can sell you on this one.
Because everybody.
What are we trying to accomplish? It's just.
Everybody tours forever now, because that's the only way most working bands make a living. You're not going to make a.
Right.
I mean,
you're not getting a royalty check.
Basically, CDs now, I think it was Tim that said that CDs are basically promotion at this point.
Yeah,
they're a business card.
You're living off your live show.
Yep.
So do you guys plan on beating yourselves up on the road for, because, you know.
No, honestly, we don't need to. We all have pretty successful lives in the sense that we have nice homes, good families, good careers. And we do this and we love doing it. We've been able to do it we've been playing together for 20 years.
Yeah.
And there's no reason to stop. Obviously, we're doing something right, you know.
There's a good balance.
I mean, if we would tour if the tour demanded us to go. You know what I mean?
Like if you get offered something
right,
big.
Right, exactly. We have no reason to beat the
The stars align, which is four dudes that got families and go to work for 40 hours a week.
Yeah.
You could get that all online and then somebody to say, let's go out for a week or two. And it's like, you know, I'd love to do it again.
Yeah.
To be honest. I mean, I don't know. But we're happy happy just rocking out the way we do it.
We won't say at our age, but at our experience, it's a lot more enjoyable to just go away for 4 days.
Yeah.
You know, leave on a Wednesday, pick a corridor, hit it, and come home and, you know,
so you're picking your moments, doing, you know, long weekends and one-offs and things like that.
I can't sleep in a van anymore. My sciatica.
Because I just saw you guys out in Westchester last week at The Note. You guys had a fun night. I tell you, the band that that played between you guys and Lion Eyes.
Yeah, it was Backwards Bay Band.
But great band. Another band I'd like to pull in.
No, those guys, we've been playing with them. I asked Mike, the singer, that night. And I think we've been playing with them guys, and actually since Sugar Daddy too, but for at least 10 years.
Well, it's like I'm really lazy and jaded, so like when I go see like you guys or like Go Clutch, I generally am off drinking with you guys backstage, not really paying much attention to the other bands. You know, I'm there, I know what I'm going to see. But I remember going out, you know, I was hanging out there and watching them, and I thought they were a pretty good band. There really seems to be some nice scenes that we're all kind of somewhat like, you know, Kevin Bacon, 6 degrees separation thing, you know, with all the Maryland stuff going on, you know, with, you know, El Grande, Borracho, and all those bands. And now there's, it seems like you guys have a nice little thing going outside that Philly area and Westchester and things like that with bands like, you know, like with Backwoods Payback and things like that.
Yeah.
So it seems to be a nice rock band undercurrent starting to swell up. Would you guys agree with that lately?
Yeah.
Yeah, I totally agree.
I agree 100%.
I mean,
the guys in Borracho had us down in D.C. and it blew our minds to see that. Yeah. We went and played, Velvet Lounge with those cats.
Dude, yeah.
Good band.
It was packed house, great band. It's refreshing. It's kind of refreshing to see underground music going the way it's going.
Well, they're playing some big show next week in Philly, aren't they? That they invited me down to. I'd like to get down to it.
Yeah,
it?
Gunner's Run.
Gunner's Run.
Yeah. Yeah, we got that together. They're going out to Shaw, Stoner Hand and Thing. Festival,
okay. Yeah,
which
yeah.
Is in Connecticut. We were on it, but we just had personal stuff. Just in general, we just weren't going to be able to make it. It was like a Thursday night, and these guys are going to do like a small little run up to there. So Mario hit me up from Borracho and asked if we could hook something up in Philly. It's Borracho, Black Tie. I think they're from Boston. And One Inch Giant from Sweden. Three bands, awesome bar, Gunner's Run, you know, so it should be fun.
I'm definitely going to come down and see those guys because, you know, I mean, Rob Queen and the El Grande guys are always talking about them, so I'm really trying to tap into that scene. What you guys are doing, start to invite all these bands in to do some live shows, because you guys all, you know, basically your bread and butter is playing live, which my motto is, you know, be able to play your shit live.
Yeah.
Why else would you do it?
Yeah.
Play in your room.
You guys are going to come back and play another couple. You're going to play some more stuff off your second album, Book of Promise, second CD. I still call them albums.
I do too.
Yeah.
It sounds cool. Player in my car. Yeah.
I'm buying a lot more vinyl now, anyway.
Back.
Yeah. So yeah, you're going to play a couple of things when we come back. I'm probably going to sneak.
So here we go once again
on
here on my show with Undercover Steve down at the Easton School of Rock, by the grace of Dave Reiser and his engineer prowess. We're going to kick in some more Kingsnake. Take it away, Abel.
Oh, because there's a lot of suffering going on with my show. I mean, basically, the whole premise of doing these shows and why I appreciate so much friends like you guys coming down and playing, because this is me, these are my training wheels to try and get this show to where I want it to be. So there was going to be some lumps in the oatmeal today, as well as, like with the Bitch Rock show, that went off so smooth that I was waiting all day for the disaster to come. And it never came. Everything went really, really smooth. I mean, Dave might disagree because he does most of the legwork here. But it was just like everything went smooth. So I knew sooner or later there was going to be some either minor catastrophes or one big one. So
it's still early yet, too.
Yeah. Well, the little ones, I mean, you know, not plugging mics in and keeping them off and things like that. And but we'll fix. That's all about post-production.
Fixing the mix, man.
Yeah, fixing the mix. It's fitting that you mentioned that, Mike, because you work at a studio, I guess, what, Philly area?
Yeah, I do most of my work. The work I'm doing with these guys is a place called Sign Studios on 22nd Street in Sansom's, a really good place. I'll check them out. So, yeah, come on down. We'd love to have you.
So now you're engineering? Like, what do you do?
Yeah, I engineering, you know, if it calls for, I've kind of stepped up my production hat, putting that on a little more, you know, people starting to ask me, what do you think? You know, what should we do? You know, kind of thing. And, you know, so it's kind of going from there. Yeah.
Have you done other bands before Kingsnake or?
Philly bands?
Yeah, like, I mean, like anybody I would know that you might work with on stuff, or anything anybody might know that you're involved with? Or are you kind of?
Well, I'll put it to you this way. I was swapping Electric Lady Stories with Dave back there because, you know, he worked there. He interned there. I was on staff there from like 92 to 97.
Wow.
I would say the most notable thing I did two things. One, this band Warrior Soul, this old band from I mixed an album called Drugs God and the New Republic for them.
Cool.
At Electric Lady. And one of the things I'm most proud of that I did at the Lady was I actually got to do a Zep set with Jason Bonham Band.
Oh,
yeah, that was really cool. Like meeting him and doing that. Yeah, that was like it was one of those things where they set up and played live. There was like 200 people in Studio A. You know, the gong will, you know, the timpani will be here in 30 minutes, you know, kind of thing. That was pretty crazy.
And I definitely want to thank you guys for coming around. And
Thank you, man.
There's a lot coming up, it's going to be a fun end of the year, I think.
Yeah, man.
I look forward to it. So thanks again for coming down and playing. You guys are going to play a couple of forthcoming songs.
Yeah. thing all day.
And you gotta bang the gun.
What's on fire?
I said, the path is on fire.